I was doing a newscast, a 10 o'clock newscast one night. I had never seen the name in my life. And in the middle of the newscast, up pops the story from the mayor, spelled B-A-A-L-S. Okay, that was Harry Baals. Finished the newscast, went into the WoWo newsroom. The phone rang about 30 seconds later. I picked it up and answered it, WoWo News. And the voice said, is Bob Chase there, please? And I said, speaking. He said, son, this is your mayor. And he says, I pronounce my name Baals.
Fort Wayne's longest-serving mayor has put our fair city back on the map. Even GPSs are taking cracks at Fort Wayne.
Recalculating. Continue 0.4 miles, then turn right on North Harry Baals Drive.
There's already a street named after former Mayor Harry Baals, and it appears through online voting, the community is ready to name a second thing after him.
There is someone standing up for the thousands of votes, Baals' great-nephew, who now goes by Baals.
If you just read the name and you're not sure, you might say Baals, you might say Baals. What do you think about all this?
Oh, I think it's kind of funny. I also think this is the name the people have voted for. I think the people should have their say.
On Monday, Fort Wayne Deputy Mayor Beth Malloy told the Journal-Gazette naming the new city-county building, the Harry Baals Government Center, was, quote, probably not going to happen.
Since it's Uncle Harry, it should be Baals. They can do it, like you said, with the street name, H.W., instead of his entire name. I don't see a problem with it.
Online voting at feedbackfortwayne.org ends Friday. John W. Davis, Indiana's News Center.